Good evening and welcome to Lillis Court at the AWC here at Loras College for what should be a very exciting game between the Loras College Duhawks and the Nebraska Wesleyan Prairie Wolves. I'm Adam Rodriguez. Joined with me today is Hugh Molony. Hugh, how are we feeling today?
Oh, I'm feeling splendid. Excited to watch some basketball. It should be a good matchup. And Adam, how are you feeling?
Good, man. It's going to be a fun one, especially for a good senior night here. Loras played Nebraska Wesleyan a few days ago at Nebraska's place and lost, unfortunately, so I know they're going to come in here wanting some revenge, especially for those seniors here tonight. We're going to get the national anthem and starting lineups out, and then we'll be right back for you guys. Welcome back. Real quickly, let's take a look into tonight's starting lineups for both teams. For the Prairie Wolves, back in the down the front court, we have number 40, Landon Tornetton, number 24, Peter Lash, number 22, Elijah Thatz, and in the back court for the Prairie Wolves will be the duo of Carter Glenn and number 3, Carter Reckenberg. And for the Loras College Duhawks, manning the paint, number 22, Jackson Kalinske. Down there with him would be number 23, Cole Navigato, and 21, Rowan McGowan. And at the back, Jake Healy, and number 3, Ali Sabet. Already have a ref stoppage here.
And we saw this quite a bit in the last game, the women's game. There's a lot of stoppages with clock issues, so maybe that's carrying over into this game as well.
Hopefully they can get that fixed up. We don't want to have to worry about that too much. Now we got to inbound the ball to Healy as soon as we get the clock fixed. While we're waiting for this, Hugh, let me ask you, who are your key players for tonight's game?
My key players for tonight, first off, going to go with our grad student, Rowan McGowan, been a key part of this team for a couple years now, and with it being senior night, he was honored as there was a foul called there. I believe that was on Healy. Jake Healy.
Yep.
Also, Ali Sabet, the JUCO transfer out of a school in Chicago. He's been balling for the Duhawks all season. A nice impact he's made on the team so far. And number 23, Cole Navigato, who just joined the 1,000-point club last game against Luther.
Yeah, great, great achievement for him. I mean, we all knew he was close, but none of us really knew how close he was. But for him to join that to be the 45th person is great. He joins his teammate, Rowan McGowan, as well. But back to Sabet, huge pickup for the Duhawks. Like you said, the transfer from Oakton. I mean, he's just, you said earlier, he's been balling, and he's averaging, 14.2 points a game, and he's been a real help for the Duhawks.
Yeah, and like you said, Cole Navigato just joined the 1,000-point club. You know, I was pretty close to that in my high school days, you know, only about, 980 points away from it, so.
I think I was around the same.
If I would have just, gotten a chance, man.
I think I was around the same numbers there, too. I feel it.
It looked like the Duhawks started off in a zone early on here, but on the inbound.
Man.
Yeah.
Back up to the top, over to Tornetton. Rickenberg up top, looking down low. Healy gets a hand on it. Looking back out to the half court line.
And
couple moves, corner, three.
Stepped out of bounds.
Stepped out of bounds.
And, the person that Duhawks need to stop here for the Prairie Wolves is going to have to be Peter Lash, the freshman. Last game, he had 24 points against Loras, and he's averaging 17.5 per game with 8.6 rebounds. Yeah. So he's going to be the key for the Duhawks to win here if they stop him.
Yeah, leading the team in points per game and rebounds per game. game. And that just goes with, I wrote it down, I think a big key for the Jayhawks tonight against Nebraska Wesleyan in the second game, they just got to limit the paint buckets from Nebraska Wesleyan. Jayhawks were outscored 52-18 last time in the paint. And it'd be good, like I said, a chunk of that came from Lash. Healy for three, no good. That's the rebound.
Yeah, and Healy's been struggling from three as well. Last game again, or against, last time they played Nebraska Wesleyan, excuse me, he went 0-9 from the field and 0-8 from three. So he's definitely going to want to get that turned around. He also did not have an overly good shooting performance against Luther either.
Yeah, and that just goes with that. I mean, Healy's a nice pass from Healy. Rowan just smoked a layup. Just kind of don't really see that from McGowan. That's bringing it up. But yeah, Healy averaging 6.6 points per game. Healy almost with the steal there. Not really known for his scoring abilities, more so his defense and hustle. He loves to dish out those assists, averaging about three a game, really being the facilitator, knowing his role.
Yeah, like you said, a facilitator. He's a grinder out there, somebody who Coach Martin trusts to have out there in those late-game situations to make the right passes and make the right plays.
Yep. Now we got top over to that left wing. Finds Quincy at the high post. Sabet driving in, easy drive to the right, misses the layup. Good tip out from Kalinske. Healy, oh my goodness, that's three smoked layups in a row from the Jayhawks. We are still scoreless about 3 minutes into the game.
Yeah, it's looking like there's a lid on both these hoops.
Seriously,
here.
Good steal from McGowan. See if the Jayhawks can get something to fall this possession. McGowan from three, good. Nice little Chi-Town from number 21.
Yeah, and it's good to see Rowan get a three early here. He's been struggling these past couple games after how he started off so hot, and it's just that UD game is where I first saw him kind of start to slip.
Yep. I mean, McGowan, like I said earlier, is part of the 1,000-point club, and he reached that milestone in 92 games in his career here at Loris. Fast break for the Jayhawks. Savetz and Navi. Navi for a little layup. Timeout called by Nebraska Wesleyan. With 16:49 left in the first half. Back to McGowan, his shooting. He is top 10 for threes made in a season. 3-point field goals, he's at 69, tied for sixth. He's the school record holder for 3-point field goals made in a career. Over 1,000. I mean, that's just knowing your strength. Shoot or shoot, baby.
That is, and that's something that he's got to keep doing. I know he's in a slump a little bit, and he's sometimes a little hesitant to shoot it, but with how good of a player he is, yep, he's just got to keep going. Got to shoot hot to get hot.
Career field goal percentage of 48.9, about 49% from the field. I mean, that's just, you never hear that percentage ever, really, and from anyone from the field.
Duhawks coming out in the press here, and it's something that they should have been working on over these past couple weeks, because we saw them one game just get absolutely blown out because their press just couldn't stop anybody. Yep. And they were awfully loose on that back end.
Yep. Rickenberg got the left wing guard by Sabet. Moves it over to Glenn.
Duhawks in a zone here. Navigato, man, the high post, making sure nothing easy gets into it.
And that zone, I like that zone out of the Jayhawks. I mean, the Nebraska Wesleyan's not scared to shoot the three, obviously, there. But they are only shooting 30% from three. I looked at it earlier. I think they were last in the ARC for three-point percentage. I mean, 30% is not terrible, so they're not scared to shoot it. But definitely something, if they live by Healy, almost kind of just broke that man there. But if they give up threes to Nebraska Wesleyan, it's not a terrible thing. He drives, gets the foul.
Yeah, Nebraska Wesleyan is only making 7 3-pointers per game as well. So it's definitely, like you said, Loris got beat out in the paint last game. That's definitely their strength, especially with Peter Lash,
yep,
who is a menace down there.
Healy at the line for two. Missed his first one, front rim.
Healy started off the season 32 for 32, and since then he's kind of been in a slump.
Yeah, it's strange. I mean, he's about 88% shooter from the line, so seeing that front rim miss is very rare. Checking into the game is number 20, Miles Berry, in for Healy. Healy will go take a little break. Jayhawks staying in that press.
And Coach Martin here putting his freshman Tyler Bass at the head of it with those long arms, looking to get a tip with just how lanky he is.
Yeah, very lanky. I mean, it's 6'6". Half of that comes from that upper body and those arms.
Two freshmen in here for the Dewhawks, Tyler Bass and Alex Singleton. Alex Singleton is somebody that Coach Martin and this coaching staff is high on. His potential is through the roof, and it's going to be exciting to see him grow over these next 4 years.
Just checked in for Nebraska Wesleyan as well, number four, Josh Rogers. Three-point basket good by Lash. I got a funny story for you here about number four, Josh Rogers on Nebraska Wesleyan.
Let's hear it.
From my hometown state, Colorado, from Arvada, Colorado. He's in my league for high school. We played him. He happened to drop 40 points against us. Unfortunate for us, but great player. So I'm excited to watch him play again for sure.
Yeah, it's always fun to see those kids you played against in high school come to a college that is in your conferences. That is a deep three.
Man. Oh, boy. Lash getting started early. As a Prairie Wolves fan, that's what you want to see. Get Lash going. You're gonna have a lot of success.
Yeah, and the timeout that Nebraska Wesleyan called is kind of what stopped this Dewhawk run. Since then, I believe Nebraska's gone on a 6-0 or even a 9-0 run.
Yep. Good little feed from Savetta Berry there for a nice little finish.
That was a good cut by Berry there. It's something that teams often don't do nowadays. They just do a lot of standing around, but if you keep moving and tires out that defense, you can get those easy back cuts.
No doubt. Rogers in the corner. Nebraska Wesleyan moving around. Dewhawks still in this. Looks like a 3-2. Oh, my God. I mean,
that was a heat check and a half.
Yeah, wow. And, I mean, Lash already at 9. He's got 9 of Nebraska's 12 points. It's going to be – it could be a good game for this man today.
They've all been from downtown as well. And he's been getting deeper every time he shot it.
Seriously. I think he's moved about 2 feet back every time.
Yeah, that last one was from the logo.
Yeah. Singleton draws the foul. Can't tell if it's on the ground or if it's at the line. It looks like it'll be on the ground. Checking in for Nebraska Wesleyan looks like number 10, Terrence Gilder, and number 30, Tyler Converse. And as well as number 15, Griffin Clark for the Dewhawks. I would pass that to Tyler Bass. He's up at the top. Singleton went for the screen, didn't use it. Foul called. Number four, Josh Rogers. That's his first. Fast inbounded from the sideline. Berry swings it over to McGowan. Pass up top over to Berry. Clark thought about shooting it. McGowan for three. No good. Talking about transfers earlier, another good transfer for the Dewhawks. Griffin Clark, number 15, senior this year as well. Transferred from Kirkwood Community College. Another good point guard. He averaged 2.6 assists per game. He can shoot the rock. It's another asset, another weapon for the Dewhawks.
Yeah, and last game against Luther, he was the second leading scorer with 9 points. Yep. And against Nebraska Wesleyan, he came off the bench and had 11 points in that loss.
Great. Good six man, if you could say. I mean, him and Tyler Bass for sure. Yeah. Great six man to have for the Dewhawks. Berry bring it up the court. Clark, we were just talking about it. Three-pointer no good. Rebound by Trenetton.
And Nebraska Wesleyan is definitely coming out here with some energy with it being the Dewhawks senior night. They're trying to be the spoilers here.
Yep. Any team plays. Whenever you go into a gym, Lash again. Oh, he misses long. That's how a lot of teams play, though. You know, you go in knowing you're the senior night game. You kind of, that gives a little edge to your game. You kind of want to spoil it for them.
Exactly.
Checking into the game for the Dewhawks, 23, Navigato Kalinski, and making his first appearance is number 25, Declan Sherlick. Sherlick's been out for a little bit. I think it was for an injury. His last game he played was on January 22nd versus Buena Vista. 10 points. It's definitely a good weapon that I know for a fact the Dewhawks miss. He just brings a lot of energy to this team.
Yeah, and against that game against Buena Vista, he hit a half-court shot at the end of halftime, too.
Oh, yeah.
It was a crazy shot.
Good move from Navi. This shot no good. I mean, he's averaging 8 points a game, so definitely those 8 points were no doubt missed for a couple of those games, a couple losses that Duhawks had. Converse pass to Rogers down low is good. Ooh. Rogers missed the layup. Good contest from Navi. Barry bringing it up, pushing a little bit for the Duhawks here. Navi, good fake there. Takes it in. Draws the foul. Foul is going to be on number 24, Peter Lash, I believe. Nope, they're calling it on number 4, Josh Rogers. Interesting. It's not really where I saw the foul, but Navi will go to the line for two.
On that last possession there where I believe it was Rogers missed that shot, it was a good job by him fronting Griffin Clark, the smaller defender, but it was even better rotation by now. I've got to come down and help side defense.
No doubt. Great, great rotation. We got a second free throw is good. Duhawks still in that press. It kind of looks like a 1-2-2 press, I want to say.
Yeah, they're going for the trap. They're trying to direct them to the corners to get those easy traps and get a cheap steal.
Gills are up at top. Drives middle. Nothing there. Over to Converse for three. That's good. Man.
Yeah, and if those wing defenders crash in like that, Nebraska Wesleyan is going to be wide open all day. So Coach Martin's either going to have to come out of that zone or make an adjustment on it.
Right. Clark drives in, draws the foul. He'll go to the line. That foul is going to be on number 30, Tyler Converse. Like you said, I mean, they probably looked the same thing I did. It's on Nebraska Wesleyan. It's not that great of a shooting team, but, I mean, they're hitting them now. So you might, like you said, they're going to want to look to switch up that defense to find something to slow them down.
Yeah, in the game of basketball, anybody can get hot at any given time, and sometimes it can be contagious.
I'd say you'd want to go a man now with Lash sitting out, but you can't really You got Turnett and down low as well, number 40 for Nebraska Wesleyan, averaging 11.7 points a game. I mean, the last time these two teams met, Turnett finished the game with 16 points. So, I mean, he's also another factor, second on the team points per game. So, I mean, you can't really give up that paint anyway, shape or form. Burnett up top with the ball guarded by Clark.
And the Duhawks did switch back to a man here.
Good D from Clark. Clark with the rebound. Got little numbers here. Navi down the short corner. Good little crossover move. Tough finish and one. Oh, yeah. Let him know, Navi.
That's a big boy finisher by Navigato. Frozen with that crossover and then used the right hand to kind of protect the shot from the shot blocker.
And Grotke's not an easy guy to finish over. Standing at 6'10". I mean, very hard to finish against someone that tall. But Navi was able to do it. His free throw's good. Over to Turnett and guarded by Navi. Here's Austin Endorf at the top of Nebraska Wesleyan. Converse at the top, key guard by Sirlik. Not sure what they're going to do with it here. Just moving it around. Sirlik guarding Endorf.
They're also doing a lot of switching here on this man.
A lot of switching. I love it. Travel call. Good defense from Healy. Great defense from the entire Duhawk team there.
Oh, and Jake Healy has some words for number 40, Landon Torrington, and I'm all for it. All for it.
Talk it, Healy. We love it.
And Jake Healy is not the biggest guy out there, but definitely hustles probably the hardest out there. He's coming into this averaging almost 2 steals per game, which is something that gets lost a lot of times in these days.
Yeah, no doubt. Healy over to Declan. Up to Navi at the top. Griffin thought about shooting it, but didn't. Guarded by Tyler Unger. Healy drives. Oh, jump stop. Clark for three. No good. Declan's there. See, and that's what the Duhawks miss, too. Sherlick is always finding for offensive rebounds, and foul from Grubke. Klinsky's down. I believe he's grabbing his left wrist, it looks like.
Foul on number 32, Jack Grotecki.
Not entirely sure.
Yeah, Grotecki came in there, and he hit him pretty hard on his face. I think he might have broke his fault as a wrist or something.
It's not never fun. Never fun. Klinsky to the line for two.
It also seems to be getting a little chippier when they're starting to bang down low in the post, and that's definitely something to look out for.
Yeah.
Only halfway through this first half.
No doubt. Checking back in is number 21, McGowan, number 3, Sabet. In for Sherlick and Clark. Klinsky's first free throw is good. Second one is up and off to the right. Endorf with the rebound over to Glenn. Glenn bring it up for Wesleyan. Into the post to Unger. He drives in on Sabet. Foul on Sabet. Unger, another Colorado native. A lot of Colorado guys there. I respect it.
Interesting that they'd go all the way out to Nebraska. You know, I mean, it's closer than Iowa, but.
Yeah, no doubt. Unger at the line for two.
Also, like, there's a little bit of miscommunication there between Ali Sabet and Rowan McGowan on that switch, which is something that defense really is fueled by, is the communication between teammates, and you see what happens right there with that lack of communication.
I love the way the Duhawks are playing defense and throwing in the constant switches on everything. I think it's really kind of thrown off that Wesleyan offense, and it's kind of slowing them down, sometimes speeding them up a little bit, and I think it's working pretty solid for the Duhawks so far.
And it looks like Nebraska's in a zone here as well.
Healy for three. No good. Good tip from Bass. McGowan at the left wing. Thought about shooting it. Saw it at the top. Swings it to Healy, left side, McGowan corner.
It looks like the Prairie Wolves are in a little bit of a 3-2.
Yeah. Ooh, interesting offensive foul call on Navi. Not entirely sure where the foul was there.
I think they called a hook, I believe.
Interesting. That's Navi's first foul of the game. Glenn bringing it up.
And Gortecki also kind of chests it up. Now we got him after that.
Charge take, Healy. It's good. Good charge from Healy. Love that. Smallest one out there on the court, and he's willing to put his body out there, put his body on the line, take hits for the Duhawks.
Coach Martin was also loving that charge, too, and he's the type of coach that players love to play for. He's a high-energy guy, and he'll always have your back.
Oh, no doubt.
The thing the Duhawks need to do here to beat this press is get him out of position by passing the ball like they're doing right now. Can't have it sticking with one player.
Almost look to hit the middle. Every time you get a paint touch, it definitely opens something on the outside for the offense. Healy looks to attack the paint. Sabet for three, right wing. Good.
Ali
Sabet from Chi-Town.
Yeah, and Ali's a 40% three-point shooter, so one of the better shooters on this team, him and Rowan, and he's also kind of been slumping from three, but he did lead the Duhawks in points last game against Luther with 11, so definitely somebody the Duhawks need to get going early.
Yeah, Unger, nice little pullback. His shot's no good. Fouling Grotecki. Good box by Bass, I believe it was. That's a trick. I mean, if you got someone that's 6'10 and you're obviously a lot shorter than them, you definitely want to make sure you're showing that box out to get that foul call on the opponent.
The Duhawks are in the bonus already with 7:48 to play.
Team fouls 9-4. Bass will go to the line.
And Bass on the year is a 77% free throw shooter. So definitely a guy you're not too mad about being up there.
No, not at all. Checking back into the game for the Duhawks is number 32, Alex Singleton. That's his first shot. 1-1, good. That second attempt is up and in. Both free throws good from Tyler Bass there. 7:45 left here in the first half. Duhawks are up 23-19. Keeley Garden-Tornet and up top. Sabet, Garden-Unger. Oh, good little feed there from Unger to Glenn.
Yeah, Torrentine for Nebraska Wesleyan kind of set a screen there on Alex, and he didn't see it, so it was a good play by the Prairie Wolves.
Yeah. That's what I noticed. Nebraska Wesleyan is very good at moving and helping each other when they don't have the ball. Healy for three. Looks off left. Singleton, good board. Offensive rebound. Finish, good.
Number 32, Alex Singleton with the rebound and the foul.
That's just something you can't coach or teach right there, is that hustle and working around to get around the weaker box out, though.
I mean, that's two straight possessions of Nebraska Wesleyan just hitting a backdoor cut on the Duhawks. I mean, for Loris, if you're going to play that aggressive, you got to be aware of those potential backdoor cuts. And props to Wesleyan. Healy for three. There it is.
3-point basket.
Healy from Chi-Town. Nothing but the bottom of the net.
That was Healy's first three of the game and his first one in a while almost. He's been struggling, and as there's a block foul.
Foul's going to be on Tyler Bass.
And Healy's only a 26% three-point shooter, so when he makes them, you're going to be counting your blessings.
Yeah, no doubt.
It looks like Nebraska Wesleyan is going to be calling timeout here with 6:28 left.
With that, Jake Healy, another senior on the team for senior. I will talk about him a little bit. His career averages, he's averaging about 9.6 points a game, close to 10 a game, 2.3 assists per game, and about 4.5 rebounds per game, along with almost one steal a game. I mean, not bad career numbers at all from your guard, your 6'1 guard. I mean, like we said, he's more the hustle guy for us, and he's that facilitator. And you love seeing someone like Healy out there on the floor at all times.
Yeah, he's somebody that every team needs to have, that scrapper, hard worker. You look at all those great teams in NBA history that always have one guy. For the Bulls, it was Dennis Rodman, and I'm not comparing Healy to Dennis Rodman, but you always need somebody with that energy that doesn't need to score to
no doubt
be a part of and affect the game.
Yep. The marketing major from Wheaton, Illinois, definitely a big, big key and piece for this Loris men's basketball program, and will definitely be remembered here for a very long time. First horn sounds. Looks like both teams are going to start coming back onto the court. It'll be Nebraska Wesleyan's ball down low under the basket. Glenn to inbound for Wesleyan.
And this Duhawk man is almost like a zone. They're just kind of, they're switching it, but
yep,
it's just like a zone almost.
Good take. Good hard take from Glenn there. Draw the foul. Foul's going to be called on number 21, McGowan, I believe. Yep, on McGowan. So Glenn will go to the line for two shots. We talked about Loris being in the bonus already, and now Nebraska Wesleyan is one foul away from joining mm-hmm. them.
And the next foul that the Prairie Wolves commit, Loris will be shooting two free throws instead of one and one.
Glenn's first free throw is good. His second one up and in. Nice little friendly roll there. Barry to bring the ball up for the Duhawks. Barry up top over to Sabet. Sabet looking around. Tyler Bassett in the high post. McGowan for three. No good. Yeah, strange to see McGowan miss a lot of these threes he's taking.
Yeah, especially with them being so open as well. And it's just, I mean, he's got good form and everything, so I think it just might be in his head a little bit right now.
Yep. Glenn with another bucket there. Glenn's just kind of tearing this Duhawk defense apart, getting to the bucket with ease. Bass, Klinsky. Klinsky, dunk, no good. Foul's going to be called on number 5, Tyler Unger. Good foul not to get that, let him get that dunk down.
Yeah, I know this place would got a little bit louder than what it is right now because I could hear the O's and the gasps when he missed that one.
No, for real. Klinsky's first free throw, good. Klinsky's shooting about 75% from the line. Usually you don't hear that percentage a lot from big man. So, I mean, with him at the line as a big, you, like we said earlier, you're not mad with someone like him at the line. Second shot, good. Glenn to bring the ball up for Wesleyan here. Pretty tight game, 30-27, with about 5.5 minutes left in the first half. Glenn's floater, no good. Almost wanted a foul there, so I bet bringing up the ball.
Yeah, not really a smart shot there by Glenn with Miles Berry all over him. Berry, one of our better on-ball defenders and one of our probably stronger defenders as well, muscle-wise.
I think that was one of his layup heat checks there, so I bet. Oh, nice fake there. Chi-town? No good. Long.
I think Ali almost thought that one was going to go in when he let go of it based off his reaction.
He was starting to back up a little bit.
Yeah. Dropped the hands right away.
Oh, yeah. Dats at the right wing. Over to Lash. Lash at the top. Guarded by McGowan. Couple moves. Crossover. Nice head. Good D from McGowan. Lash. Fadeaway. Almost made it. Wow. Dash is an offensive rebound. Good board from Dash. Jump ball. I think it's going to stay here.
And Thatch is somebody for the Prairie Wolves who's really just started to play more recently. He's only, I believe, played 13 games so far this season. And he started five of them, and I believe those have been the last five games in a row.
Another Colorado native. Love it.
As it looks like the manager, Luke, is cleaning up a sweat spot on the court.
Had a baby, Luke. Flash at the right corner, guarded by McGowan. Up to Glenn. One thing with this Nebraska Wesleyan team, they lead the conference in total rebounds a game. 12 and a half, close to 13 of those come from the offensive side. So as Duhawks, you definitely are going to want to get a lot of bodies on these guys as they are very aggressive going for those O boards.
It looks like they call a foul on Roan McGowan.
That's his second. Lash will go to the line for two here. I'm sorry for his 1-1. The first one's good. Checking back in. Number 23, Cole Navigado. In for number one, Tyler Bass. Second free throw, good. Navi inbound to Clark. Clark will bring it up. The Duhawks. Nebraska Wesleyan still in that 2-3 zone. I mean, it's working pretty well with how the Duhawks have been shooting right now. Navi drives in, draws the foul. I believe that's going to be called on Peter Lash. That will be his first.
Yeah, Navigado had the right idea there. He's going to hit Kalinske on the back cut, but Nebraska Wesleyan closed that up quick, so he drove in and got the freshman, Peter Lash, to commit the foul.
Navi's first free throw is short. Healy checking back into the game for McGowan.
Yeah, and for Roan, even when he's struggling, he can still affect the game in so many ways because if not, I've got him miss both free throws there. He can either – defense is still respect him because he's developed that reputation over his career, so they're going to guard him either way, even if he's cold or not. So that opens up other people for the Duhawks.
Yep. Nice little and one take there. And they turned a lot of their focus to Lash, making sure he doesn't do anything, and they kind of just open stuff up for Glenn. Glenn's averaging about 11 points a game. He's third on the team for points per game. So, I mean, definitely somebody you don't want to give up a lot of easy lanes to because he'll take them. He converts the and one. Bass inbounding to Berry.
Like you said, he'll take his lanes. He's not much of a three-point shooter, only making 10 threes this season on only 35 attempts. So he's shooting 28%. So definitely somebody who's looking either more to drive or facilitate.
Clark, Chi-town, no good. Sherlick there for the old board. Clark drives in, out to Declan. His three, no good. Wesleyan with the fast break. Klein leading the charge.
Oh.
Ball pushed from behind from Bass. Will go to the line. 1-1. First free throw, good.
Glenn is a 75% free throw shooter on the season, so definitely above average and a reliable shooter from charity stripe.
Glenn's definitely having a much different game against the Duos right now. Last time these two teams met, he only had 6 points. I mean, he's definitely not the same guy that we saw. Oh, man. Oh, Navi with a nice little throwdown.
Cole, put him on a poster. Send that one and sign it to
me. Oh, man. Clark with the beautiful feed.
That was on his head.
Declan foul there. Oh, man. I think the shot clock's still – I think the bucket's still moving
a
little
bit. Oh, my goodness. I got my blood pumping. Jeez. I kind of saw it coming, too. I saw his eyes light up. Uh-huh. I saw him get the gather step. I was like, oh, baby.
He caught it. He had that one, too. Oh, we both knew where it was going.
That was a good way for him to avoid the shot blocker, too, bringing it around and look fancy with it, too.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my.
Reichenberg at the line for Wesleyan. His first one was good. Second one up and in. Pass inbound over to Sabet. Sabet will bring it up for the Duhawks.
Yeah, and in the last game for Wesley when they played Loris, I believe Peter Lash played 33 minutes and Landon Tortentine played 39. So
Archery is good.
So definitely somebody that Nebraska Wesleyans rely on heavily. And for Lash only being a freshman out of North Carolina, that's definitely something they're going to be looking forward to for these next 4 years.
Yeah. I mean, there hasn't been a time this game yet, and I know for a fact their last game, too, where they're not on the court at the same time. I mean, one will go out, but the other will stay in. If Lash goes to the bench, Tornetton will still be there, and vice versa. Duhawks with numbers. They're pushing a little bit. Sabet goes. Clark stepped out of bounds. But, yeah, you really won't see those two leave the floor for Nebraska Wesleyan very much at all.
Mm-hmm.
A lot goes through those two. Duhawks back in that 1-2-2 press here.
Duhawks were a little confused there at the beginning. Mm-hmm. Ali and Griffin Clark were on the same person.
Yep. Glenn up top with Sabet guarding him. Can't tell. I think the Duhawks are in all.
Yeah, they're back in that zone they started the game off in.
5 seconds on the shot clock. Good take from Eichenberg. His finish no good. Bass at that board. Poked from behind from Glenn. Almost turned it over there. Declan Sabet swings over to Clark. Thought about shooting it, but didn't. Sabet, big, drive it right. To Navi. Navi, a little short corner jumper. No good. That's an unfortunate miss. In and out.
And that's kind of Navigado's shot when he's not driving in. It's short corner is about as far out as he'll go.
Flash of that smooth jump from that high post area there. Flash is shooting about 31% from three. So, I mean, you don't really want to give it up, but we've obviously seen it. But it's better just to stay down on those three-point attempts from him, close out. And one.
Number one, Tyler Bass.
Tyler just used his length there and his strength and went up over the defender and got that bucket to fall.
It's those high energy plays the Duhawks need. Like Navi's dunk, that and one. Keep that energy there for them. I mean, it's a 1-point game here. Could tie it up after this free throw. We might have a game on our hands here in the second half.
I'm excited. A minute 17 left. And Duhawks are down by one.
Free throw, long.
There's been a lot of lead changes as well throughout this game.
A lot of lead changes. Glenn bring it up middle. Moves to the left. Pass over to Thatch. Up to Converse at the top. Converse drives left. Out to Glenn. Sabet guarding. Glenn driving a nice little spin there. Glenn is really finding his groove down low. He's at 18 in the first half.
Yeah, him and
Hart, Hightown. Oh, Singleton almost was going for that putback there.
That might have been a little bit of a heat check there for Griffin.
No doubt.
Oh.
Glenn. Whoa.
That was a weird-looking shot.
Yeah, not expecting it.
It was like a floater almost. And it was, I don't know, it was weird.
Very weird. Glenn up to 21. I mean, Duox really don't have an answer for him right now.
It looks like Nebraska Wesleyan's still in their zone.
I mean, why go out of it? Duhawks are definitely struggling from three, so as coach Nebraska Wesleyan, I definitely do want to stay in that zone. Navi from the corner, his three, good. Oh, yeah.
Navigado's first three of the season, couldn't come at a better time.
Seriously. Good D from Sabet. Navi from the corner put him at 12 points. Going into the half, Prairie Wolves up 43-40 over the Duhawks. Theo, what are you liking from the first half of this game here?
First half, I'm liking the energy that the Duhawks have been coming out with. It hasn't been – I think they've almost had more energy than the Prairie Wolves, but the Prairie Wolves are just hitting their shots and kind of picking apart our zone when we're in it. So second half, I think Coach Martin's going to want to adjust that zone or come out of it, and the way he'd adjust it is not crashing down on that high post, just let him go one-on-one.
Man, if I'm watching the stream, I want to see that Navi dunk again. Man,
100%.
That thing was nice. About good energy play. We'll get back to you after the halftime is up. We'll catch you in the second half for more Loris and Prairie Wolves action here. We'll be right back. Oh, welcome back to Loris College for second half action of Loris College versus Nebraska Wesleyan men's basketball. Loris currently down 43-40 after a very exciting first half. A lot of good basketball was played. Before we get back to the basketball action, we want to shout out a couple other Loris teams, starting with men's volleyball. Traveling, they're at a little tournament here. They played Fontbonne University earlier and won 3-1. Junior Dorian Fiorenza led the team with 16 kills. I mean, I love watching that man play men's volleyball. He's about a good 6'4", and he's got a lot of bounce under it. On his legs, and he gets up and he really hits some nice kills there for them.
Yeah, he is an animal on the volleyball court.
Him and Pat Mahoney. Cannot forget All-American Pat Mahoney. Those two are a lethal, lethal duo for the Duhawks men's volleyball team.
And switching over to my area of expertise, the track. Our men and women are split today. Not everybody's running. At Whitewater, the people who are competing, both men and women are in fifth place. So best of luck to them the rest of the meet.
Best of luck to them. And men's volleyball playing again later today, I believe at 3 o'clock. Best of luck to them as well. Hopefully they can keep rolling. I think they're on men's volleyball is on like an 8-game win streak right now. They're playing very well. One of the better teams here at Loris for sure. Back to basketball action. Like I said, it's 43-40. Prairie Wolves over the Duhawks. Laura's shooting about 30% from three. Definitely not one of their better shooting performances. I mean, they are averaging about 39% as a team from deep. So 30% not the best for them, but I wouldn't be surprised if they start to fall. Cole Navigato leading the way for the Duhawks with 12. And Carter Glenn leading the way for the Prairie Wolves at 21. Definitely look for those two in this second half. I wouldn't be surprised if Peter Lash for Prairie Wolves starts to get things going, and if Ali Sabet and Ron McGowan get the wheels turning for the Duhawks.
Yeah, Navigado's only Duhawk in double figures, and nobody else is close. The second closest person is Griffin Clark, and he's got 5. So yeah. The Duhawks really spreading the wealth, but not much wealth to be spread around right now.
Not at all. Duhawk starts ball in the second half. Navi on the left wing over Sabet. Sabet bringing it around over to Healy. Takes him right baseline. Good take from Healy.
Whew.
He was high enough. He could have thrown that down if he really wanted to.
I saw it. I was like, oh, my goodness.
Turnett and up at the top for the Prairie Wolves. Guarded by Kalinske over to Glenn, the hot hand. Lash wouldn't have been surprised if he took that three there.
Yeah, last, since he hit that logo three, I think he's only taken one more, and that was his last one after, I believe, he airballed it from the corner.
Yep, he's been pretty quiet after that miss. Tornet in the corner, good D from Healy there. Tornet in good move, good spin, finish no good. Foul called on Healy. kind of a soft foul call, if I'd say there. Don't know if I really agree with that one. That's Healy's third. Healy's definitely in some foul trouble here.
Interesting they called over the back when Healy is the smallest person out there.
Seriously. I mean, I don't really know how you can. And he wasn't really getting boxed out either,
no.
So I don't know how you can even say over the back. But turn that over to Glenn. Glenn, nice crossover. His tape is good. Good finish on the left side. Still feeding the hot hand. He's up to 23. Healy over to Navi. Navi to Sabet on that right wing. Feed to Klinsky at the elbow. Navi for, thought about the three. Block on Turnett. Way to draw it, Navi. Way to draw it.
Yeah, and like you said, rest wasn't still feeding the hot hand with Carter Glenn. He's shooting 8 of 10. So only missed twice, 5 of 5 from the free throw line, 2 of 2 from 3. So definitely not just getting layups.
Talk about, when you say riding the hot hand, they are doing it for sure here. Navi to Healy. Healy on the right wing. About 13 seconds left on the shot clock. McGowan in the right corner. He uses Navi's screen. Makes that man fall off the screen. Navi, layup no good. He wants a foul, but obviously the ref didn't think there was one. Glenn leading the charge. Just bobbing and weaving through the defense. Lash up top. Guarded by Sabet right now. Klinsky. Guarding Turnettin.
Yeah, Navigata might have to be careful here with how much he's talking to the refs. Last home game against Warburg, he did get ejected at the end of it.
Interesting. Lash tried to draw a foul there. Thatch with the offensive rebound. Again, back to my point earlier, Reichenberg for three.
Ooh.
That hurts. 48-42 Prairie Wolves after the Reichenberg's three. Back to the point earlier, like I said, Nebraska Wesleyan getting about 13 offensive rebounds per game. If you're Loris and you want to win this game, you have to box out, especially in the second half. This is the time to fix those little things here.
And the thing the Duhawks could easily take advantage of is how loose Nebraska Wesleyan has been with the ball all season. They averaged close to 14 turnovers a game, meanwhile only having 12 assists. So it's definitely a ratio that helps out the Duhawks.
Sabet, great take from Sabet there. He's up to five. Way to come off screen there too.
Yeah, it was a good job by floating using his left hand. He is left-handed, so good job by him just using that dominant hand and floating it over. I believe that was Peter Lash.
Saw that Garden Reichenberg up top. Dash catching it about the wing. Lash for three. Air ball long.
Yeah, Lash has really cooled off since the beginning of this game.
First three threes, yeah. Sabet, that left wing, over to Bass, swings to Healy. Sabet looking to get it in. Bass guarding well. Sabet out to Navi. He's in the short corner. He takes Torrenton. Good fake spin. Good. Good finish there from Navi. I mean, we're talking about being cold and being cool and not hearing from anyone. Talk about McGowan. I think 4 points.
Yeah, and I don't even know. He's missed a lot of threes today that have been fairly open that we've come to expect him to make. He's shooting 1 of 4 from the field and 1 of 3 from three.
Way to draw the foul there for Bass. We have McGowan leading the team in points per game, too, with 16. So
yeah.
For him to be at 4, I mean, when we talked about it, he's been in a slump lately. But, I mean, 4 is just not really what you expect from Rowan.
Yeah, and the only other stat he has besides those points is 2 personal fouls, so he's not doing anything else out there besides taking those shots.
Hopefully he can figure it out here in the second half, help the Duhawks.
Yeah, the Duhawks are going to definitely need him, not just this game, but in the conference tournament as well.
Yep. On the foul call, and it's on the floor. Interesting. Thought he was going up with it.
And the thing that Navgado does well, especially on that layup he made against Landon Torrentine, is he is much smaller, but he just uses his strength and speed to get around him.
Bass, big body down low. He's up to 6. Tie ball game here, 48-48. Gilder up top for Nebraska Wesleyan over to Glenn. Lash on the left wing, guarded by Tyler Bass. McGowan guarding Glenn. Glenn, take. Man, I feel like everything that the kid's putting up is going in.
That's a matchup I don't feel too good about for the Duogs, having Rowan McGowan on Carter Glenn. Rowan's a good defender in his own way, but Glenn is a much faster player than Rowan.
McGowan draws the foul. Foul will be called on the three, Connor Reichenberg. Checking into the game for Nebraska Wesleyan, Josh Rogers in for Reichenberg.
And if I was Coach Martin on defense, I'd maybe not box and want it, but just don't switch on Carter Glenn.
Down for Chi-Town. Ooh, in and out. That's going to stay here. Last touch by Nebraska Wesleyan.
And that ball was basically almost to the bottom of the net when it came back out.
It's pretty much in.
But, yeah, I think Coach Martin might want to put Miles Berry or Tyler Bass on Carter Glenn.
Definitely. I'd like to see Bass on him just because he's so long. And he could easily get a steal on it. If he's going to contest, he's got a good chance of blocking that shot, too.
Yeah.
Berry outlet to Clark. Clark up at the top. 16 seconds left on the shot clock for the Duhawks. Clark drives in. Pump fake, no. Berry drive baseline. Finish, good. Right over Cornett.
Number 20, Miles Berry for the Duhawks.
There it is, Berry on Glenn. Over to Rogers.
And what Miles Berry brings to this team off the bench is he started quite a few amount of games, so.
Oh, wow. Really?
I thought that one might have been off Nebraska Wesleyan.
Yeah, interesting.
But, yeah, like I said, Miles Berry started a few games at the beginning of the season, and since then Healy's kind of taken over for him. So that's somebody Coach Martin can rely on off the bench that has had those big-time minutes.
Yeah, well, towards the beginning of the season, Healy was nursing an ankle injury. Definitely, like I said, Berry saw the court a lot more than he does now, but when Barry's in, he utilizes his time when he's on the court. Bass on Glenn. Singleton out in Tornetton. Good D from Singleton. Good hand. What a forced shot clock. They didn't steal it there. Sabat bringing it up for the Duhawks.
Got a mismatch. Carter Glenn's on Alex Singleton right now.
Yeah, feed it to Alex.
Nebraska switched to a zone again.
Back in that zone. Duhawks moving around. Bass. Sabat drives to Bass in the middle. Nice little floater there from Bass. Good dish from Sabat.
Yeah, like you said, good pass. He faked that to Griffin Clark and drove in, attacked the middle of it, and Tyler Bass with a quick little floater.
Yilder up top, guarded by Sabat. Over to Lash. Singleton on him. Now Sabat. Rogers catches on the wing. Drive, spin. Layup, no good. Good D from Clark. Singleton with the board. He's going to bring it up. Over to Berry. He's going to move it. Over to Sabat. Sabat for three. Chi-Town. Yeah. Oh, there we go. Here come the Duhawks. 55-50. 13 and a half minutes left.
That's all I think Ali needs to get it. Oh, my goodness.
Everything is going for this man.
Kissing it off the glass.
Good take from Glenn there. I mean, it's good defense from Berry. I mean, he contested well. Sabat came over to help. But Glenn's just able to throw it high enough to where it, like I said, nice little smooch off the glass.
Yeah, and Glenn's only played 23 minutes and 27 points, which is absolutely insane.
Yeah, very, very shifty guard, very quick. Morris doesn't really have an answer for them. For him, I should say.
Yeah, he's really the only reason that Nebraska Wesleyan's really stuck in this game.
Yep. Like I said, I mean, with Lash going quiet, going cold, Loris is doing a great job with Lash, but now they got to try to shift some attention to Glenn, slow him down.
Like we talked about how Glenn's really the only reason Nebraska Wesleyan's in this game. Besides Glenn, only five other people have scored, so Nebraska Wesleyan's only had six people score this game, which just shows how much Carter Glenn is doing for these guys.
Really, for real. Still in that zone over Clark. Clark from the wing. Chi-Town, yeah. Could have been an and one there.
It was a three Clark,
very
two on the wing.
Clark. Clark is about a 40% shooter from three. So, I mean, anytime he Turnitin's layup no good. Anytime Clark puts up, I'm kind of expecting him to sink it out to Bass. Bass for three. Another one? Nope. Missed short. Singleton almost with that offensive rebound. Glenn bringing it up. Interesting foul call. But Glenn will go to the line for two here. That's going to be Barry's first foul. Glenn at the line for two here. First one, no good.
And for Glenn to get to the line there, he really just used the Duhawks not being ready in transition and just used that burst of speed and got past Miles Berry.
That's right. Nebraska, like, I mean, that transition, Nebraska Wesleyan's had a lot of success. I mean, they like to move it. Whenever they have that opportunity, they love to go fast. Glenn's second free throw is good. Healy bringing it up for the Duhawks. Healy's got to be careful here on defense and even on offense, too. He's got three fouls. Healy faked the three over to Singleton. Singleton drives. Nice finish. Nice finish from Singleton.
That was a big boy finish by the freshman, just going up and over them.
No doubt. Took the contact and everything. Feed to Rogers. Foul is going to be on number 15, Griffin Clark. That's going to be his first foul of the game. Taken back into the game for Nebraska Wesleyan is number 30, Tyler Converse. In for Terrence Gilder. Up to Tornetton at the top. He swings it to Lash. A little mismatch here. Good help from Bass. Singleton. Singleton at the board. Glenn almost came around and was poked out of Singleton's hand. Strong enough with the ball. Healy drives. Clark to Healy. Healy, three. Short. Flash the rebound. Glenn kick over to Tornetton. Tornetton for three. Good. Ooh, that was smooth.
It kind of feels weird now because the Duhawks kind of went on a little bit of a run there. It kind of seemed like they're up by more than just 4 points right now.
Yeah, I thought they were going to be up by eight when I looked up at the scoreboard.
Yeah.
Really on the shot, so I bet. Pump fake. Duhawks moving around. Clark in the corner. Yeah!
Oh, he's heating up.
He's feeling it right now. He's up to 11. Second Duhawk in double digits. Hand down, man down. So I bet guarding Converse up at the top. Pass to Rogers, three. Yeah, I saw a lot of those threes back in high school. Saw a lot of those. Not surprised that one in.
That was a good pass. Tyler Bass kind of sank down there, and I think he was expecting it to go down in the middle of the paint, which I kind of was too, and then he threw good. It to the corner.
Yeah, definitely. Josh Rogers is not going to miss those open threes. I can say that from experience. Duhawks up 63-59 here at the timeout. I mean, they came out hot in the second half. They are all business right now. They do not want to lose this game, I can tell you that for sure.
Yeah, Nebraska Wesleyan came out and hit a couple threes early, and the Duhawks kind of shut that down ASAP, and now we are going to have ourselves a good finish here the rest of this game.
Yeah, I would not be surprised if this comes down to the last minute, last few seconds of this ball game. We'll see. We're definitely in for an exciting one. Still halfway through the second half. The first buzzer sound. Teams will get ready to come back onto the court.
And the thing that the Duhawks are really standing out here is from the free throw line. Nebraska Wesleyan shooting 92%. Meanwhile, the Duhawks are only shooting 68%.
So that's kind of strange. Loris is pretty good from that area shooting.
And Loris is getting out-rebounded by 3, 21-18, but Loris is actually winning on the offensive rebounds battle 7-4, but they're getting out-rebounded by 6 on the defensive side.
Clark thought about shooting that. That would have been a heat check, no doubt. Clark on the left wing, over to Healy, swings it to McGowan. Oh, yeah. Clark, left wing. No good. No. Surprised there's no foul call. Home.
Getting a little fancy over there, yeah, Haley.
Good save from Haley.
Looks like Dark's going back into their press.
Yep. Let's see if they can slow him down here. Clark, I think, got a hand on it.
Yep.
Call there. Almost steal from Clark. That would have been very nice.
Kind of a poor spot for Nebraska inbound the ball in that area right there.
Yep.
You got to get it across in 3 seconds. Oh, plenty of time.
Yeah. Flash and Glenner in the back. I mean, that's just easy. That's just so easy. I was going to say, yeah, when I saw him get back in that press, I was kind of unsure. Nebraska Wesleyan was kind of tearing the press up a little bit.
Yeah, the Duhawks have been struggling on their press all year. It's just once they get past that half court mark, there's nobody back to defend the hoop.
Mm-hmm. It's just so aggressive up in the back court.
Yeah, they really get out of place because they got three people up top and then usually only two people there, so that means you got two people guarding three back here, and they usually never take the guy on the bottom by the hoop.
Healy to inbound the ball for the Duhawks here.
Oh.
Just going to stay with the Duhawks. Just on the sideline this time. Up to Clark. Clark covered by Converse. Duhawks moving it around here. Looking to get something to Navi. Navi drives in. Oh my gosh. Missed the layup. That's unfortunate.
That was painful. That one just rolled around the rim.
That's a bummer. Glenn bringing it up for the Prairie Wolves. He's got 30 right now.
Still got 10 minutes to play.
Yeah. Hunger, left corner. Oh, Healy almost at the steal. Oh, blocked by Kalinske, and Healy comes down with that rebound. You're not going to get a lot of shots over Kalinske. Clark from the corner. Yeah!
Oh, he's got takeover.
Oh, yeah.
He's got takeover.
Oh, he's got the flames under his feet here.
Sharp shooting takeover.
Turn that up the top, guarded by Kalinske. Clark's up to 14. Glenn, no good on the layup. Haven't seen much of that today.
Oh, he wants it. Pull up. Oh,
I thought he was about to. He drives in. Kalinske finishes at the rim. Oh, yeah. Here go the Duhawks.
Looks like Carter's going to try and slow this one down here. Stop this momentum from going on the Duhawks side as Nebraska was. It's going to have a group sub change here.
Oh. Hunger just smoked the layup. Healy bring it up. Looking over at the Clark. Another one.
Oh, baby.
Oh, yeah.
Come on,
he is feeling it.
Coach Martin is going crazy.
What a senior night for Clark.
Let's go.
17 for Clark. I mean, sir, what a night for this man to start going crazy from three.
Griffin Clark's like, I'm going to wake up today and be a menace to Nebraska Wesleyan. Oh, he's got some swagger to him out there, too.
He's shaking his head over to the students over there. They love it. They are going nuts over there.
Oh, my gosh. Coach Martin, I wish we could have had a shot of that. He was going crazy. Yep. He was hyping up the crowd.
The entire bench was up. Nebraska Wesleyan with an entirely new lineup. I mean, they're just...
Yeah, that lineup was... they're out there for, I believe, a majority of the second half. They might have been getting a little tired.
They're in shambles right now, so it looks like.
I know. Carter's been out there basically this entire game. Yeah. So... and a travel call.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they are. Nebraska Wesleyan is looking a little rattled right now from Duhawks. Huge momentum shift. Up 10, 71-61.
And if Griffin Clark gets open for a three here, boy.
It's going to
go
nuts.
This place would go even more nuts. And I want to see it. Oh,
Another one. Come on, baby. Oh, man. We were both getting up out of our seats here. We were both practically standing up. Klinsky almost blocked that three from Gotecki.
A little bit of a push off there.
Charge?
That ref wanted to blow his whistle over there. I saw that.
Flop
warning. Just give a flop warning to
Rogers draws a foul and one. Wow, that was a very That's a tough take from Rogers. He'll go to the line for his and one attempt. That is McGowan's third foul. Rogers to potentially convert the and one. Free throw is up and good.
I mean, that was a good timeout by the Prairie Wolves. It really kind of took the wind out of the sails after Clark hit that three.
Yep. That's Quincy. Over to Clark. He's got Reichenberg on him. Healy drives. Too easy for him. Too easy. Blow by. I mean, they have no answer. The rest of us has no answer for the Duhawks
they
right now.
Not,
they
no.
are, I mean, they just, they can't break this lead right now.
Yeah, on that play right there, they went to play the screen. They played a little too hard, and Healy decided to go away from it, and he had a wide open layup.
Yeah, great read from Healy. I mean, we can't talk about him more, but Griffin Clark showing up. 17 points. Really? He's been a huge factor for this Duhawks run, and their energy on that bench.
Yeah, and it's been almost all season as well. He's kind of been that unsung guy that just gets things done. You know, he's averaging around, I believe he's averaging
about 7 points.
Seven
a game.
Points a game off the bench is nothing to scoff at. And today he's shooting 5 of 10 from three. So,
oh
my goodness.
Yeah. When you're on, you're on. I mean, he is showing it that he is on today.
And, I mean, keep shooting. Got to shoot to stay hot.
Yeah, shoot or shoot, baby. Shoot or shoot. Would not be surprised if anytime he catches at the three, and he even has the smallest amount of space, it's going up.
Yeah.
Would not be surprised. Like you said, I mean, coming off the bench, the 7 points, I mean, it's a sneaky 7 points.
Oh, yeah.
We said it. He brings that energy. He's not, obviously, I'm sure he's scouting reports, but I'm sure he's not one that's, like, labeled.
Yeah.
You got to go guard this man.
Kind of like what I was kind of thinking about with Carter Glenn coming in today. Somebody
no
I didn't
doubt.
Really have circled.
No doubt.
And then he comes out and drops 30 so far.
Yeah. No doubt. I totally agree with you on that one.
It looks like he's still out of the game here for the Prairie Wolves.
That starting five, yeah, they are all on the...
Except for
Reichenberg. Other than
and
that,
Thatch.
And Thatch, yep. Other than that, those other three, they're... Three leading scorers are on the bench.
He must be. I'm thinking he's probably going to bring him in at either a 7 minute or a 6 minute mark because that's when they're going to have to make this push if this group out here doesn't cut it down.
Kick ball from Healy. I think they're in that like 3-2 zone again. Rogers for three. Oh, good. Rotecki. Foul called, I believe, on Cole Navigado. That's his third. Going to the line will be Jack Rotecki for two. His first long off the back iron.
And he's only a 60% free throw shooter on the year, I believe. Shooting 14 to 23.
Second one, good. Healy to bring the ball to the Duhawks. Out to McGowan. McGowan from the corner. Short. Still just has not been able to find his groove today.
No, he hasn't. That was a good pass by Healy as well. He kind of like floated in the air on the sideline to get that one to McGowan, who's wide open.
Great skip pass from him, but just short on that three. Healy down on
Healy
the ground.
Healy got hit in the face, I think.
Rogers from three. Rogers now up to nine. Navi driving on Rogers. Layup no good. Klinsky can't get the rebound. I believe it's going to...
Oh.
Going to Nebraska Wesleyan. Interesting. I think this change of lineups for the Prairie Wolves was kind of a good thing for them.
Yeah, got some guys out there, some fresh legs, and...
Oh, travel.
Travel.
slipped and just caused him to travel.
Ali Sabetchek back in for Griffin Clark.
Let him get a quick breather.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't be surprised he comes back in real soon. Navi drives. Yeah, they wanted the charge call there. Someone's open.
If you just gave him a flop warning, that'd be the second one of the game, I believe.
Navi thought about shooting it. Rogers on him. Up to McGowan up top. Over to Salbet. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Do I have to get a shot up here?
I think Ali Sabet can take this guy.
Oh, yeah. Oh. No call there on the three. Okay, sure. I think they're about to call flop on Sabet.
I remember the ref called a flop warning on number 10 for Nebraska Wesleyan.
There's a flop warning on number 10, Terrence Gilbert.
Oh, they're calling it on Terrence Gilbert.
Yeah. When he flopped on the Navigato.
On the top charge of the key. Tape.
Yeah.
Yep. Gilbert's drive, Healy guarding him. Out to Thatch with Navi on him. Reichenberg drives left. Navigato contests, layup good. Second lineup from Nebraska Wesleyan. Bring the Prairie Wolves back.
This lineup hasn't been able to get much going.
No.
They've had their open shots, but just haven't been able to hit it.
Nope. Nebraska's defense has gotten a lot more aggressive here late in the second half. Sabet driving left, nothing there. Guarded by Grotecki.
I think the Duke should clear out when Grotecki is on Ali.
Force layup from Healy. No good. Gilder drives. Healy on him. Bringing it out. Slowing things down for Nebraska. Over to Rogers. He's guarded by McGowan. Grotecki outside. Guarded by Klinsky. Over to Gilder. Gilder drives. Ooh. Air ball. Nice little move that just couldn't finish.
That was a good defense by Ali, too. Great just defense. Staying up in his face and not biting for the step backs.
Oh, yeah. Healy bringing it up.
As Peter Lash checking back in for the Prairie Wolves.
I was wondering when he was going to come back into this game.
I don't believe we said his name.
We've.
Yes, the second half.
I mean, we've said it once and he airballed it. But Navi at the right wing over to Sabet up top. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Sabet drives the defense from Rogers. They got to get a shot off here. McGowan's got a chuck. Oh, man. Long. Good defense there from Nebraska Wesleyan. They are not letting Lawrence get anything.
Good defense.
Good defense
for Healy.
Oh, that's going to be a get there, Klinsky. Klinsky get there.
Oh.
Good.
Nice.
Oh, good hustle there from Duhawks. Navi up to 16 after that layup.
Yeah, and Coach Martin really willed Klinsky to get that ball. He's telling him to go get it, and it was a good pass to Navigato, and it looked like, I believe that was number 10, Terrence Glider, who just didn't want anything to do with Navigato.
He
didn't want another poster.
He remembered that dunk from earlier and said, I think I will pass.
He said, that's a no for me.
No, thank you. Duhawks up 75-70 here at this timeout, late in the second half. That second lineup, I mean, we talking about the lineup, they were doing a lot there to slow down the Duhawks, and I think that was definitely good for this Prairie Wolves team to slow down that momentum, take Griffin Clark out of the game, and I think that definitely Nebraska Wesleyan took advantage of that for sure.
Yeah, and right now Lash is sitting at 30 minutes, so it looks like he's going to finish the game around 34 minutes, so that's a lot of time out in the court there for a freshman player, and Glenn's only at 27, so it'd be interesting to see. I'd almost feel like it'd be Lash, Glenn, and Torrentine out there to end it for the Wolves. But
I mean, Lash averaging 34 minutes a game, so yeah, not. I mean, yep. There's Torrentine and Lash both back out there. Surprised we're not seeing Glenn out on the court with that. Especially
I'm sure he's kind of surprised he's not on the court either.
And he's got the hot hand for them too.
That hot hand might be a little cold now. He's been sitting on the bench for around, like, 6 minutes,
I
think.
For real. Healy with the steal. Ooh. Wow. Sir. That is going to be Healy's fourth I don't think anyone here in this gym agrees with that call. No. I don't know if I really agree with it, but that'll send Reichenberg to the line for 1-1 here.
Yeah, Healy is still shaking his head over there on the free throw line. Ball don't lie, though.
Another foul call. I don't want to be on Tyler Bass. I mean, that's just, you can't have that happen. You can't let Lash get the offensive rebound off that free throw.
I believe Lash came across the paint for that one as well.
Yeah, I mean, that's just a good move from a big down low for a rebound. First free throw up. Good.
That's Lash's first points of the second half.
This is the second one. Lash is an 81% free throw shooter. To see him miss that second one, very surprising.
Looking at Carter Glenn on the bench, his body language doesn't look overly good right now.
Bass, tough take, and one! Oh, yeah. That is a big body take from the freshman there.
Let him know, Tyler.
Bass will go to the line to possibly convert this and one. I believe Glenn just entered the game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he was sitting over there at the front of the bench, Glenn was, and his arms were crossed. He was just slouching the chair and didn't look overly happy.
Sure, he was a little upset he wasn't in this game.
Yeah, so it's going to be interesting to see how he comes out to play this last 3 minutes, 20 seconds.
Lowers up 78-71 after the Tyler Bass converted and won. Over to Reichenberg, so I bet guarding him. Healy out guarding Glenn at the top. Glenn drives. Oh, wow. Nice pull up. Oh. Just missed it left. Healy bringing it up.
Yeah, he kind of got Healy stumbling backwards on that hesitation move, but just couldn't convert on that mid-range jumper off the back iron.
Glenn out guarding Healy. Over to McGowan on that right wing. Morris moving it around, trying to find something here. Oh. Foul is going to be called on Thatch. That's going to be his third. Yep. McGowan will now go to the line for a 1-1. McGowan 87% from the line. Yep, that's not surprising at all. First one's down. Checking back in, number 20, Miles Berry, in for Alisa Bett.
Yeah, that's Coach Martin switching now offense for defense there with the Duhawks coming back on defense this possession.
McGowan, second free throw. Good. He's up to 6. Yep, Berry right away already on Glenn.
There's definitely a defensive line the Duhawks have out here with Berry, Healy, and Bass.
Oh, good steal from Healy.
He
had Bass wide open on that right side. Not a bad idea to bring it slow down. Glenn guarding Healy out top. Swings it to McGowan. McGowan guarded by Lash now. Ooh, Lash tweaked his ankle a little bit. Oh, good hustle from Berry. Dash with a nice little fast break layup there after the turnover. Duhawks up 80-73, the minute 50 left in the game.
Yeah, I think Rowan just got a little too comfortable there. Yeah. After he saw Lash kind of tweak his angle, he just got too loose with it.
Healy looking to go with it. Timeout call from Loris. Martin's a little upset the ref didn't hear him the first time.
Yeah, I think he said about two or three times the ref was just right there and just ignored him, it looked like.
Gotta love it.
That ref is looking a little grumpy as well with Martin talking to him.
So upset he was in his ear just trying to call for a timeout.
Looks like Rogers checking back in for the Prairie Wolves as well.
Surprised we haven't seen Clark come back into the game.
Yeah. I don't know. I think it's maybe because Coach Martin's not... Because Clark hasn't really played in these types of situations all season. So I think Coach Martin's going to go somebody out there you trust a little bit more, like the five he's got out there right now.
Yeah.
And with the Duox being on offense, kind of surprised that he's not subbing Ali Sabet back in the game either, with him being one of our better free throw shooters.
One of the better free throw shooters, and then just someone that's able to attack the paint and finish at the rim with ease. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if all of a sudden they just toss him in, but...
Yeah. And the Duogs will only have 12 seconds on the shot clock as well, so that's something to keep in mind.
Yeah, they're going to have to get something going pretty quick. 3 seconds left in this timeout. Both teams are walking back out onto the court. Buzzer sound. About a minute and a half left in the game. Oh, I believe Rogers came in for Glenn for Nebraska Wesleyan.
Yeah, this is definitely a taller crew, taller squad that got out there right now.
Yeah.
Glenn is
two,
fairly small.
One, block from Cornetton. Good D, good help from him. Gilder bringing it up for Nebraska Wesleyan. Up to Thatch. Thatch to Cornetton at the top. Guarded by Bass.
Gildner and Thatch were part of those two that kind of brought Nebraska Wesleyan back into this game. They're part of those five that were out there.
Good D from Navi. Cornetton. Put back good. Yeah, this timeout called by Nebraska Wesleyan, 80-75. Yeah, this might come down to the wire here.
Yeah, that's something I'm looking forward to this last 56 seconds. I want me a close game as Ali and Griffin Clark are checking back into the game.
Not surprised. I need a little offense. They've gone scoreless here the last.
Yeah. I'm going to expect Coach Martin to use all 30 seconds of the shot clock and get it down to 26 seconds. That puts Nebraska Wesleyan between a rock and a hard place, really, because then they got to make every shot, and then they got to foul and hope we miss.
But, I totally agree. Would not be surprised if they focused on winding the clock down. Don't want to do anything dumb to let Nebraska Wesleyan get the ball back and come down and make it a 2 or 3 point game.
Yeah, I'm trying to see who the Duogs have in the huddle right now. It looks like it's Clark, Ali Sabet, I believe Navigado's down there. Oh, we'll see in 8 seconds, though.
Yeah. we'll wait for both teams to walk out on the court. Lash right now for Nebraska Wesleyan. Only one in double digits in the lineup that they have out there.
Kind of surprised that Coach Martin's leaving Navigado in this game if it comes down to free throws. Navigado only being a 69% free throw shooter compared to Kalinske's 74%. So.
Yeah.
Maybe just putting Navigado out there for speed-wise and purposes as they break this with ease.
Break it so easily. Yep, here comes that. Winding down the clock. Flash on Sabet. I think I like this matchup a little bit here.
Yeah. Ali's kind of toying with him out there, it looks like.
Yeah, he's just dribbling it out. Timeout call with 37 seconds left. And 11 seconds left on the shot clock.
30-second timeout. I kind of expect Coach Martin to maybe draw up a lob-type play to get a quick bucket, only if it's wide open to throw it.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I'd expect them to do an outlet pass and use this last 11 seconds on the shot clock.
Yeah, just get one of those last-second shots off for the shot clock. First horn sounds. 10 seconds left in the timeout. Nebraska Wesleyan is probably going to come out looking for a steal, no doubt. They're going to want to get a steal here or just force Loris to take a shot that's not not what they want.
I think the shot that they're going to want is Navigado about from 15 feet and beyond. As Lohr sees it, their second to last time out.
Good defense from Nebraska Wesleyan, not letting the Duhawks get anything out of that inbound play, not even like the outlet pass to half court. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's...
They're kind of rushed coming out as well. They had a couple players running on late.
Yeah. I mean, the ref handed that ball out early.
Yeah.
We'll see what the Duhawks can do here. Still 37 seconds left, obviously, since they didn't even get the ball in. But we'll see what they do here.
Wonder if Coach Martin's going to try and go back to what they just ran, or it looks like they're flipping sides from where they were last time. A little four flat here.
Kick ball, and it's going to stay here.
Good job by Navigado. It really beat Lash off that line after that back step.
Sabet's going to inbound it this time instead of Healy. Not entirely sure what was called there.
I'm not sure. I'm going to say 20 or 24.
No idea what's going on here.
They're saying something about the kick ball, so they said the number.
Both teams are going to the bench as the referee talks to head coach Wellman. Yeah, we're unsure of what is going on right now. Wish I knew.
Maybe it was someone with the shot clock because he kicked it. So instead of it being 10 seconds, it moved back up to 20. I'm sure that could be something he's talking about.
Okay.
This is the third different inbounder we've had.
Yeah, we will go Healy, and then Sabet was going to throw it in.
Oh, what a catch.
Wow, good catch from Clark.
Type of guy I'd want on my team playing dodgeball.
No doubt. Clark's going to drive. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Oh. Clark bobbled it.
Making me eat my words, that bobble.
It's not a turnover that unwanted.
That is unfortunate.
Rogers charged, throws it off the side of the backboard. Fielder drives,
give it to him. Oh!
Interesting. He looked to be the set there. It's going to be Clark's second foul of the game. Gilder will be at the line for a 1-1, unless they give it as two shots. Oh, they're getting him two shots here.
Looks like Tyler Bass and Kalinske are going to check in.
First one's good from Gilder. 80-76 Duhawks with 11.5 seconds left.
Griffin Clark coming out of the game as well as Ali Sabet in exchange for Jackson Kalinske and Tyler Bass. Kind of a surprise.
Interesting.
They took Ali out of the game.
Yeah. Second one's good. Timeout called by Nebraska Wesleyan. 80-77. 11.5 seconds left. Yeah, we got ourselves a ball game. And we had a point where it looked like Loris was really about to run away with this game.
Yeah.
I thought they were going to keep it at that double-digit lead. Nebraska Wesleyan, what a smart smart move by Coach Wellman over there to throw in that second lineup to really change their pace and momentum.
Yeah, and this has kind of been a struggle for the Duhawks all season. It's kind of closing out these games. They always go on runs, but then they allow the other team to go on those runs. And it's just some games they'll be down by 10 the whole time, they can get it within 5, but then just right back it goes back to 10-12 points, and that's something I know Coach Martin's going to want to work on, not in just this game but going on forward and then eventually in the end of the tournament.
Yeah, but no doubt the smarts from Coach Wellman. I mean, obviously you're going to see that Wellman's got multiple conference titles under his belt and including a national championship, so I mean, there's a lot of brains over on that sideline from Wellman. So definitely a smart move out of his playbook to switch those lineups.
Looks like Coach Martin brought back in Ali Sabet and Griffin Clark. So a little confused on why he brought Kalinske
in. Probably for that rebound, just in case they missed that free throw. Russ Wesley's going to foul, and they're going to put the leading free throw shooter at the line.
Roan really just needs to make one of these with Nebraska Wesleyan being out of timeouts in this game.
Yep. Nebraska Wesleyan's going to bring back Glenn and Converse. And Loris looks like they just brought back in Tyler Bass. Definitely doing the offensive-defensive switch again. Rowan at the line. Free throw, no good. Oh, that is very surprising.
That's smart.
Good smart foul. There, smart foul.
It's a smart play there by Tyler Bass. Allow them to tie that game up.
And, I mean, McGowan missing that free throw. It's just, again, that goes with what we were talking about a lot earlier in the game. I mean, it's just that groove. He's just not found his groove these last few games.
No, he has not, and it's been a bit of a cause for concern for these loyal Duhok fans.
Well, no doubt, especially coming into the tournament, to the conference tournament, you definitely want to see him find that rhythm. He's a big part of this team, and for him to not hit those three-pointers, I mean, he's known for those threes, obviously, the most threes in his career. Grotecki has a chance to tie this ball game up at 80.
The good thing is, though, for the Duhok, he's only shot in, I believe, 23 on the season. 23 free throws. He's only a 60% shooter. As the fans are starting to get into it.
They're getting into
this. 4 seconds.
They realize it. First one. Good.
Oh. Good thing is the Duhok still do have one timeout left.
What are they choose to use it?
Are you thinking he purposely misses?
No, I'm thinking he should try and make it.
He makes it?
Yeah.
Send it to OT possibly?
Yeah. I think that'd be the smart play because if you miss it on purpose, you don't necessarily get that rebound and you can miss it.
Duhok still have a timeout left.
Oh, he
missed it. Rebound, Sabet. Duhok's. Oh, they got a foul.
Yeah, based off Gortecki's reaction there, that was not a purposeful miss.
No, not intentional there. Definitely not what he wanted there at that line. No. I mean, you can see it in his face right now. He is he is upset with himself. I mean, the Sabet leading the team with shooting about 90% from the line right now. So, I mean, this could put the dagger in it, but you never know. 0.8 seconds is enough time to just
chuck it,
launch one down court.
And the Duhawks have to be smart here if Ollie does make both. That's smart.
Smart. Ooh. Smart. And Duhawks are going to come away with an 80-79 victory against Nebraska Wesleyan here on senior night. That's got to feel good for them. I mean, leading the way, senior Griffin Clark, what a senior night for him. I mean, you couldn't have written it up any better. Same with Navigado. Navigado was 16, Clark was 17. Great game from the Duhawks. Everyone played great.
Yeah, that was a great game, and it got a little closer at the end than I'm sure most of us would have enjoyed it being. But that's the thing about sports. These close games show you what you're made of.
No doubt. No doubt. I mean, like I said, Clark and Navigado, and the highlight, my favorite play from this game has got to come from Navigado with that dunk down low in the first. But
that was
great game from them. Loris moves to 16-7 and 8-6 in ARC play. They play again on Monday, I believe, against, Luther again?
Yeah.
They play Luther again. Hopefully they can go into that and get another revenge. I believe they lost Luther earlier, so hopefully they go in and get a win there. And we'll catch you next time for more Loris men's basketball. Have a good one.
Keep it real.